Fossilized remains of various ancient animals have been regularly found by people for several centuries. Previously, giant bones were considered the remains of dragons, griffins, and other mythical creatures. But over the last two centuries, science had made significant progress in understanding the nature of these animals. Scientists have learned especially much over the past 30 to 40 years. Modern research methods and an increased number of finds make each of them more informative. But some fossils have become milestones in the study of dinosaurs. They help to better understand their habits, lifestyle, and the process of development of reptiles over almost 200 million years. Today, we will talk about several such fossils. By subscribing to the Age of Dinosaurs channel, you can not only learn about various prehistoric creatures, but also receive notifications about new episodes before other users. Also, all your comments are important to the creator of the channel. They help make our content better and more informative. And with the help of your likes under our videos, more and more science lovers around the world will learn about them. Scientists have gained almost all their knowledge about the era of dinosaurs thanks to the fossils they've found. The process of formation of such fossils is called fossilization. They are formed as a result of the destruction of the soft tissues of dead animals and the filling of voids in the skeleton with mineral compounds. Scientists estimate that such changes occur in about 1% of all animal remains. Of this small part, only a few fall into the hands of researchers. But the crumbs of new knowledge obtained from each discovery gradually make it possible to form a holistic picture of the life of the planet of those in distant times. The first dinosaurs discovered and described. The very first description of a fossilized dinosaur bone can be considered a drawing by naturalist Robert Plant. In 1676, he published the book Natural History of Oxfordshire for the English King Charles II. At that time, the designated fossils meant all finds dug out of the earth. Therefore, in the section on stones and minerals, the scientists placed an image of the lower part of the femur of enormous size. The description of the find said that this bone was too large for a horse or bull, but small for an elephant. The scientists suggested that it belonged to a giant. Another 100 years later, Richard Brooks, based on Plant's description and illustration, gave this bone fragment a name that is translated from Latin as human scrotum. Despite the very distant resemblance to this organ, for a long time, this was associated with humanoid giants. It was subsequently recognized that this femur was part of the skeleton of some kind of dinosaur. Before the advent of Darwin's theory, scientists started from the divine version of the origin of life. The presence of remains whose age far exceeded the supposed date of the creation of life was not even considered. All of them were considered to be the bones of animals and people who did not survive the global flood. Often these finds were recognized as the bones of cyclops, unicorns, dragons, and other mythical creatures. In 1822, a doctor from the County Sussex, Gideon Mantell, acquired or independently discovered a large tooth. Eminent scientists of the time, including Georges Cuvier, considered the find to be a rhinoceros tooth. But a few years later, Cuvier admitted his mistake and said that this tooth could belong to an extinct large lizard. After consulting with specialists from the Royal College of Surgeons, Mantell found out that modern iguanas have teeth of a similar structure. In 1825, he presented his research to the scientific community. In it, the lizard was called iguanodon, that is, iguana tooth. Later, this species of dinosaurs was named after the scientist. In 1824, another English explorer, William Buckland, described a type of dinosaur called Megalosaurus. We told the story of this discovery in one of the previous issues. In 1854, life-size sculptures of these and several other dinosaurs were made of concrete and put on public display. Of course, these models are very different from the modern understanding of these types of dinosaurs. By the way, the term dinosaur itself appeared only in 1842. It was coined by naturalist Richard Owen. Tyrannosaurus Sue. In 1990, aspiring paleontologist Sue Hendrickson discovered a Tyrannosaurus rex skeleton that was the most complete and possibly the largest ever discovered. It is approximately 73% preserved and was named after its discoverer. After a lengthy lawsuit between scientists and the owner of the land where the bones were found, Sue's skeleton was sold at auction for almost $8 million. Scientists were able to begin a detailed study and description of the find only in 1998. Sue the Tyrannosaurus is now on display at the Natural History Museum in Chicago. His length during life, according to various estimates, was up to 13.7 meters, and his height at the hips was about 4 meters. This giant weighed almost 8.5 tons. Sue's skull is almost over 1.5 meters long. The dinosaur reached this size at the age of 19, and he died, presumably, at the age of 28. Dinosaur parental instincts. Some fossil finds from the age of dinosaurs have shed light on how these animals cared for their young. In 1923, an expedition led by Roy Andrews discovered the skeleton of an unknown dinosaur in Central Asia. It was located close to the egg laying. Scientists believe that the eggs belonged to a protoceratops, and this small theropod was a hunter of the eggs of other dinosaurs. Because of this, it received the name Oviraptor. But new discoveries and studies made in the 90s of the last century showed that Oviraptors were caring parents. The clutch discovered in the 1920s belonged to these dinosaurs. Although Protoceratops also showed serious care for eggs and young, they were discovered by members of the same expedition in the Gobi Desert. A group of researchers hoped to find traces of distant human ancestors there, but as a result, many new species of dinosaurs were discovered. But scientists learned about the parental instincts of these three-horned dinosaur ancestors in 2011. A nest containing 15 well-skeleted, newly hatched babies were discovered in Mongolia. This suggested that at least for the time after hatching, the parents looked after the babies. But the best parents among dinosaurs can be called Miazrov. These large hadrosaurs were discovered in 1978. They lived in North America approximately 77 million years ago. The name of this species translates as caring mother lizard. The fact is that an entire colony was found in a small area. It took scientists almost 10 years to dig up and study all the remains. Among them were bones that belonged to both adults and young animals. Many nests and eggs were also found. It's possible that these dinosaurs collectively cared for their young. Fighting dinosaurs. Another interesting discovery related to the previously described Protoceratops told scientists about the relationship between predatory and herbivorous dinosaurs. In 1971 in Mongolia, an international team of scientists found the skeletons of a Protoceratops and a Velociraptor mated to each other. The predator's claw ripped open the victim's neck and most likely damaged an artery, but the Protoceratops grabbed the enemy's right hind leg and broke it, knocking the Velociraptor to the ground and crushing it with its body. In this position, both dinosaurs died from their injuries and were swept away by a sandstorm. Unlucky Hunters. A discovery made in Germany in 2009 is very indicative of the dangers of life in the age of dinosaurs. These fossils are about 155 million years old. In the bottom sediments of that time, the remains of a small pterosaur, a fish resembling a modern herring, and a larger ray-finned fish, Aspergillosaurus, were discovered. After studying these fossils, scientists suggested that the pterosaur, hunting a small fish, was attacked by another predator. Aspergillosaurus, whose body length could be up to 1 meter, jumped out of the water and grabbed the pterosaur, which was carrying its catch in its beak. The unlucky aquatic predator failed to swallow the flying lizard. At the same time, the bones and tissues of the wing were tightly stuck in its narrow mouth. All the animals sank into the water and died at depth from the lack of oxygen. Transformation into birds. Now, there's no doubt that many dinosaurs were covered with some kind of feathers. The latest of them had plumage very similar to that of modern birds, which in fact are also dinosaurs. But the first dinosaur to have feathers was the Cynosauropteryx. It was discovered in 1996 in China. It was a representative of the Compsognathidae family. It weighed no more than 1 kilogram and grew up to 1 meter. Based on discovered fossils, it was covered in primitive filamentous feathers. Modern analysis methods have made it possible to determine that this plumage was very bright. The tail was striped with white and orange, and the back was orange. The belly was light, and the legs were dark. The theory about the relationship between dinosaurs and birds arose at the end of the 19th century after the discovery of the Archaeopteryx. And one of the very first birds to have a beak was Confucius ornus. This primitive bird lived in China approximately 120 million years ago. Warm-blooded reptiles. Conversations about the possible warm-bloodedness of dinosaurs arose in the scientific community after the discovery of the Deinonychus. By all indications, this medium-sized feathered theropod was an active and highly mobile predator. This behavior is completely uncharacteristic of cold-blooded creatures. The remains of this North American dinosaur were discovered by the famous paleontologist Barnum Brown in the late 30s of the 20th century. Fossilized evidence of the era of dinosaurs includes both the preserved bones and skulls of giant lizards and their imprints in the layers of various rocks. They are supplemented by footprints, finds in frozen amber, and various indirect signs. In this issue, we included only a few finds that were studied at different times and had different values for science. But each of them is interesting and unusual in its own way. The appearance of each such fossil can once again completely change the understanding of long-extinct animal species. We thank the viewers who watched this video to the end. For those interested in the history of dinosaur research, we recommend paying attention to a previous issue. In addition to animals from the era of dinosaurs, they're devoted to the history of the emergence and development of life on the planet, problems of human society, and ecology.